Good morning, children. So in the previous PPT, we have studied about the organization of leech. So in this class, we are going to see about the organization of rabbit. So leech is an invertebrate animal and rabbit is a vertebrate. So we have already seen an invertebrate example as leech. Here, we are going to see about the rabbit's external morphology. So see the diagram of rabbit. So what are the parts present in the rabbit? The head consists of ear, eye, mouth, and then it has a short neck, and then trunk. Trunk has an upper arm and lower arm and tail. So shape, size and coloration. The body is elongated and cylindrical body. Both the male females are same in size. Well, colors from white to black, and body is covered with fur. Fur na mudi theriyumla, body division. Now the body division is divisible into four main parts, that is head, neck, trunk and tail. Already we have seen in the previous picture. Now head is a ovoid in shape, flattened. And it has a snout, long snout, and mouth, external ears, eyes, nostrils, and vibrisse. So vibrisse is like a hair found in the nostrils, and it was a mouth is bounded by upper and lower lip, and it pair of large movable external ear is present. Neck. So neck connects that the head and trunk. Trunk divisible into thorax and abdomen. Namak irukra maadi thorax. Thorax and abdomen. Females have 4 to 5 teats or nipples are present, and trunk bears a pair of pentadactyle limbs. Dactyle means fingers. Pentana 5, dactyle na fingers. And then tail. Tail is short, used to give signals to other rabbits in the event of danger. So by giving signal through the tail, it alert the other rabbits. Integument. So some structures are derived from the integument, that are hair, claw, nail and glands like sweat gland, sebaceous gland and mammary gland. So namakku sweat gland irukku, sebaceous gland irukku, mammary gland irukku, adu maadhiri adukku irukku. And then mammary gland secrete milk and nourishing the young ones. Sweat and sebaceous gland regulate the body temperature of rabbit. Good morning, children. So in the previous PPT, we have studied about the organization of leech. So in this class, we are going to see about the organization of rabbit. So leech is, so now digestive system. This is the first system we are going to see in rabbit. So digestive system in rabbit. The alimentary canal associated with the digestive glands, and it has mouth, buccal cavity, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, cecum, large intestine and anus. Mouth is bounded by upper and lower lips. It leads into the buccal cavity. Buccal cavity leads into the esophagus. Esophagus open into the stomach and followed by small intestine. So cecum is present where the small and large intestine meets. At that place, cecum is present. It contains bacteria. It helps in the digestion of cellulose, which was eaten by the rabbit. That is, the grass saapidumbo adhula cellulose digest pandradhukku cecathula adhukku bacteria irukku. And small intestine opens into the large intestine, which has colon and rectum. Rectum finally opens into the anus. So you can see the picture now. Esophagus, stomach, and then pancreas, liver, digestive glands are there. Then small intestine and large intestine, cecum. You can see the cecum. It is convoluted, a long structure which was present in the cecum. The cecum is human. It is a large structure. Cecum, human is very smaller size. That is appendix. Human. In our body, it is not in use. So it was gets reduced. Full softer animal kandipa idu theva, and so it has a long and multiple convoluted cecum is present in rabbit. It was accommodate many bacteria to digest cellulose in grass. Then colon, rectum, anus. So salivary gland, gastric gland, liver, pancreas and intestinal glands are present in rabbit as digestive glands. Salivary gland in mouth, gastric gland found in stomach, liver, pancreas pour their secretion in the first part of the intestine, that is called duodenum. And intestine, small intestine has a glands. So dentition abdina teeth. So existence of two teeth in the lifespan of an animal, that is called diphodon, dentition. So the first set of teeth is called milk teeth and second set of teeth is permanent teeth. This also happened in human being also. Then dentition of rabbit is heterodon because it consists of four kinds of teeth: incisor, canine, premolar and molars. So dentition of, you can see the dentition of rabbit in the picture. So premolars are there, molars are there, incisor is there. Then there was a gap between the incisor and the premolars, no canine at all. So that gap is called diastema. It is very, very important. It holds the large bulk of grass or vegetation while it's eating. It has a gap. So that gap is called diastema. What is diastema? A gap between incisor and premolars. It has no canine. Instead of that, it has a gap occupied by a gap. That gap is called diastema. Then dental formula. So I means I na incisor. 2 by 1. Upper 2 na mele kuduthiruka letter la upper jaw, keela kuduthiruka la lower jaw. கெனைன் வந்து கிடையாதுன்னு சொன்னோம், அந்த ஸ்பேஸ் தான் வந்து டைஸ்டீமா. 0/0. ப்ரீமோலாஸ் 3/2 அண்ட் மோலார் 3/3. ஸோ அப்பர் ஜாவில் 3, லோயரில் 3னு அர்த்தம். ப்ரீமோலார் அப்பரில் 3, லோயரில் 2. ஸோ த டோட்டலி த ஃபார்முலா இஸ் ரிட்டர்னஸ் 2033 1023. So a gap between the incisor and premolar is called diastema. So, what is the need of diastema? Helps in mastication and chewing of food. Mastication is in the food, the vehicle, the chew, the gap, the help.